how do you know if a horse is in pain or any discomfort?
This is related to the other one. I thought it was interesting that both questions got voted high up.
Yes.
It must be a point of concern with people. And again, this was not an area that I had done a lot of previous work in, so mm-hmm. Quite a bit of research when I saw this floating up there, you know? But again, I appreciate that people are making me do this because I'm learning a ton, and so now I get to share it with people. But I think I've said it like 40 times today, no normal.
Okay.
If you know what your horse acts and eats and interacts like normally when he is different, then you know something's up. Mm. And it could be pain or discomfort. That's the first sign they're not acting right.
Yeah.
I read something online by Dr. Nancy Deal, who's a practitioner, but I thought really, really wise, and a horse owner. And she said, create a catalog of your horse, of the horse's normal set of behaviors, inside the stall, outside the stall, when you're working him. There's actually a name for such a thing.
What is it?
It's called an ethogram.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. It's a sign.
What is that?
Yeah. Well, so it's a chart or table of all the different kinds of behavior, actions, activity observed in a particular animal species.
Mm.
So there's ethograms by species. And there's, I found the U.S. Department of Interior has an ethogram of free-ranging feral horses that is amazing.
Really?
It talks
that
about...
That must be really fascinating.
It is. It stayed up way too late last night. It talks about locomotion, how they move and why. It talks about feeding behavior, play, investigative behavior, maintenance behavior, grooming.
Wow.
It's
detailed.
It just puts everything that horses do in these different categories. And then you look and you say, well, these all things are normal. So if I see anything else, cribbing is not in the ethogram. That's an abnormal behavior, an action or activity.
So there might be something going on with
your
horse. Yeah,
so you're looking for those. So make your horses, make an ethogram for your horse.
I love that.
I know, isn't that fun? So now, after that, like a horse-wide ethogram, they've moved on to facial ethograms. And there's science going on out there. We have no idea. It's really interesting.
This is so fascinating. So what's the facial one?
Okay, so they've named it the horse grimace scale.
Horse grimace scale.
You know what I mean? Grimace.
Yeah, like okay. Facial. Like,
yeah. So there's a scale that, and I think maybe we'll show it. I found one from Colorado State University, the vet school out there. And it has pictures of horses and the face they make when they are in pain.
So.
And this has been validated and studied and confirmed. And
is there like one specific type of face a horse makes when in pain, or is there like a range of?
Like there's muscle tension, mouth open, the eyes do something. It's on a scale. So when there's a little pain, they have a little bit. When there's more pain, there's more.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's something that would be dangerous for me because I'm already someone prone to like, do they look a little off today or not? Like, and I will overthink to a degree. So now
because
I'm gonna be like,
there's
looking
scales.
At his eyes.
It's like a body condition scoring scale.
Yeah. Okay.
Now, one step more. You better like put your seatbelt on.
I'm ready. Bring it on.
So the next step is Dr. Sue Dyson, who's one of my favorite people. She's an investigator, a veterinarian from the UK. Her and her team developed a facial ethogram specifically to riding.
To riding?
Dun, dun, dun. Yeah.
So like while you're on, there's a face that your horse will make to see whether they're in pain or not.
That's it.
That is so cool.
And so she has developed this instrument that is useful in determining if a horse is lame or sound based on the facial expressions it makes while being worked.
And sometimes we were talking about this, they specifically also mentioned pain, so it's not even just necessarily lameness or something of that nature. So the horse could be having like back pain and still kind of look.
It doesn't localize
yes.
the pain, but it just says the horse is experiencing discomfort from somewhere.
So
now your job, the vet's job, is to
figure that out.
Yeah.
So it might not be like a limping step while someone's riding.
Yeah, it could be back pain. Back pain is a great example because back pain is actually something else that she studies.
Okay.
She's one of the world's
glad I tied that in. For
I know. She's one of the world's premier saddle fitters.
Oh.
Yeah.
Perfect.
And how saddle the fit of the saddle has to do with the way the horse goes and its comfort or not. But she, the facial markers showing the greatest significant difference between lame and sound horses were ears back, tipping the head, the eyes partially or fully closed, tension around the eye, squinting, intense stare, an open mouth with exposed teeth, and then severely above the bit.
Okay, yeah.
So she had a variety of people assess horses, videos and live horses and pictures even of different expressions, and they were really on target. And then to show how on target they were, she took the same horses that were lame, did a nerve block to take away the lameness, and then the facial expression went away, and the reviewers, the test reviewers, noticed it, and then they had checked them on this box before, and then after the nerve block, they said, nope, they're fine now.
This is so fascinating. It's probably one of the most interesting studies
Isn't it?
I've heard.
Yeah.
I am very curious to see how your own ethograms, though. I'm sure a lot of people are going to try them at home.
And do, yeah.
Definitely keep us posted with how that goes, and if you guys have any tips of how to keep track of all that.